shooting star candle. So the shooting star is an indication of sellers overpowering the buyers. So this is essentially is a little bit of the reverse of the hammer. So we have a trend going up, and then suddenly we have a shooting star, which is a candle that looks like this. At the end, usually at the end of a trend, we have this star formation, where sort of star in the sky, if you like. Okay, what are the criteria? So this body of the candle should close near the bottom. We have a small body, we have a long wick, which needs to be twice the size of the body itself. Ideally, we want the candle to close as weak as possible. And again, this is an indication that it's either time to exit your trade, if you were in the buy in this case, and it's time to exit, or if you are looking to sell, then we have the trend and we identify this candle, and then we have the next candle closing bearish and we have the sell. So again, stick to those shooting star candles which are with a long wick as long as possible and close below. Close lower, close bearish. So we can have another one. If we just ignore this one for a moment, we can have a shooting star that also looks like this. And if the open is here and it closes here, this is a bullish one because it closed higher. However, it is still an indication of selling pressure because of the wick. So you can see here, this last candle looked like a sort of hammer. There was a lot of buying pressure, and suddenly the selling pressure as the candle went down and up and then right back down and closed lower, we can see that selling pressure overwhelmed, it won over, and then we had the candle close, and then we had even more selling right here with the next candle. And again, just like with the hammer, if you have two shooting stars in a row, for example, like this, and then like this, and the trend was going up, then this is a very good indication that there is a large amount of selling pressure and gives extra confirmation to your setup. So now let's have a look at some examples. So here we have one example. We can see that in this case, we have a level of a zone of resistance, and we are looking for the market to reverse, to go to sell, to go enter our short somewhere around this area. Now what we need to wait for is a confirmation, and what we can see is we have had this shooting star, and what happens here is we have the long wick, we have the small body. In this case, it did close bullish, but it is still a valid candle, still a valid shooting star, even though ideally we would have wanted it to close below, to close further down here. So despite that, what we can do is just wait for another confirmation, which we have had right here. We can see a very strong bearish candle, and that signifies weakness, and we can now place our trade with an entry, stop loss, and a take profit. And we can see that that candle, which is now weak, bearish here, has confirmed the shooting star, and that creates the trade for us. Okay, That is one example. Here is another example, slightly different one this time. We have, in this case, a market that is trading within a range, and we're looking to trade either side of the range, and we can see that the market has hit the top part and we've had the trend, and suddenly right at the end of the trend we have that shooting star looking candle. In this case it closed lower, so it's a bearish one, and that's a good indication. We have a long wick as we need to, and we have the body, small body, closing lower. So we just wait for that indication. We have confirmation on the second candle and we can place our trade with all the parameters. So in this case we had a push down and the market went back up again, but the reversal did happen, if only for a short period. And you can do the same thing with trends. So if you do have a trend and you're looking for the market to start to catch the continuation of the trend in a certain zone, a certain area, then we can look for, at the end of this little trend here, we can look for that candle with a long wick for that shooting star and for the continuation to the downside. So those are just a few little examples of the shooting star. So thank you very much for watching. Look out for these hammer and shooting star reversal candles to time your entry, and also at the end of a trade that you're already in, it's also a place that you may want to exit. So those are the two candle formations for today. Thank you very much for watching. See you on the next video.